Hey guys, welcome back to Chicken Cindy's, and today we're going to talk about this pump. Hey guys, I got my daughter helping me again today. So this is my Lezyne pump, if that's how I say it. It might be Lezyne, I think it's Lezyne. But this is called the pressure overdrive pump. Basically, what you do is you fill this chamber filled with air, and then you'll put down this foot pedal, which I'm not sure if you can or can't see it, but it's not important. But you put down this foot pedal, and then it'll let all the air come out like it's an air compressor. So I've done quite a few tubeless setups with this, and I think it's terrific. So I'm gonna do a tubeless conversion real quick, and I'll let you know how it goes. She's just burning circles, isn't she? So let's set up some tires. I got two sets of 29er 2.4 Ardents. I've really been wanting to run these tires, so I figured I'd do one front and one back. So let's get them on and see what happens. All right, guys, there are plenty of videos of showing people how to take tires off and on, so I didn't worry about showing you that part. After I get that off, I will screw on this bad boy. So now, make sure the foot lever down here at the bottom is up, and then I will start to air this chamber up. So typically I go about 160-ish, and that seems to do it for me. I think the actual recommendation is 140. I think that's what it said in the instructions. Don't quote me on that, but I just feel like 160 does a better job of making sure it does seat the way it needs to. But it doesn't take too awful long to get to this point, but obviously, the more pressure that's in this container, or the canister, the harder it starts to get. But if you're riding mountain bikes, I'm sure there are climbs that you do that are harder than this. So I typically like to pick the tire up. I just feel like it helps with the airflow. But then all you do is take the foot lever at the bottom, flip it down. So there was one little bead. There is a dent in the rim right here. And you can see that that did stop that from going all the way. So I heard one little seed or bead pop over. So let's go ahead and do it again. Typically it only does take one time. There we go. Cool. So, sounds good. I don't hear any hissing, but here, let me get behind the rim or the camera so you can see that there is the tiniest dent right here, but that kind of stuff messes with it. So, two tries to get that one, but as I said, to be expected. So, let's switch to the next tire. I went up to about 170 in the pump, and let's see if we get a first try. There we go. Yeah, so like I said, typically it's not an issue, but like I said, I'm pretty sure it was because of the dent in that front one, as this one was no issue at all. So it sometimes keeps some air in the chamber and that's just releasing all that, but you can definitely feel this is probably close to 30 PSI. Give or take, it's pretty hard. But then after you get that done, you just do your fancy, what should we call this? The sealant jiggle, the waddle. This time for Africa. So, but that is using this cool Lezyne pressure overdrive. I really hope that's what it's called. That's what it says on it. We'll find out. But, ooh, that gets pretty hot from the friction of pumping it up. But I really like this. And since I don't have like a workshop or a work shed or something like that, this has come in really big handy for me. Really, really big handy. Sentence structures, that's probably close to right. But I think it's a great pump. I'm pretty sure I got this on sale. I've had this for about, oh geez, I've probably had this for about 2 years. I've had this pump for a while. But it typically doesn't let me down. I got two new tubeless set tires for the Ragley build. So hopefully that Ragley will be in about a week or two. They said towards the end of July. So we'll see what happens. But as usual, guys, thank you so very much. And until next time, take care.